guys, it's Robyn from Fiesta Sports here, checking in, making sure everybody is staying active during our break off. I'm about to do some tumbling outside of my garden, so I thought it'd be perfect for you to join me. The sun is shining, the weather is absolutely beautiful, and what better to do than stay active outdoors? So let's get into a warm up and have some fun. Okay, so it's time for us to warm up. We're gonna do three different exercises back to back, no breaks in between, and we're gonna get the heart pumping, the cardio going, and get ourselves ready for our tumble session. I'll do a demonstration. In fact, I'm gonna do it along with you so I can get fit too. Star jump, snaps, let's go. 10 of them. Okay, we're now going to go into clasp T jumps for 10. Okay, and for our final one, we're gonna go into some leg kicks. We're gonna do 10 on each side. Okay, so now we've raised the heart rate, I'm going to take it into a little bit of mobility, starting from the top of the body. I'm going to do this with you, so if you want to join in with me, let's go. This stretch, we want to be trying to push our hips as close to the floor as we possibly can. And then we're going to sit back. Toe touch shape, and we're going to fold over to one leg. We're going to reach our hands around the middle and stretch all the way down and all the way over to the other side. The legs in. We're going to walk our hands down our feet and sit straight back up. Again, walk our hands down. Make sure we're keeping a nice straight line under our legs. We don't want any bendy knees. Keep the legs nice and locked and fold down. Okay, we're going to go into a jump shape, the hurdler. We take it from a toe touch. One leg bends through. I'm going to reach down to that straight leg. And we're going to change legs. Okay, we're going to go into a tuck position and we are going to do 5 rocks in an egg roll ball. Okay, let's flex those hips and legs out a little bit. Bend the front knee. Make sure that your toe stays visible and that your knee doesn't go past it. And let's work on stretching this angle. We're going to turn the leg out to the front, the stretch through the side. Change our legs. We're going to stand up, shake it off, and we're ready to go. Okay, so to make our session a little bit more fun today, we are going to play a game called the Dice Decides. So I've put a little screenshot of what the different numbers on the dice will mean. Those of you that come to my clubs will already know this game, but for those of you that don't know or haven't played the game, what we do is we're going to roll the dice, whichever number it lands on, that will organise our session for us, so it's a little bit more fun to make it creative. Now, I'm going to roll for our first one to see what we're going to do to start off with. So, here goes. I've rolled a 1, which is nice and organised, so that means we're going to start with forward rotations. Let's give it a go.
We're going to go into some forward rotational skills, like forward rolls. So I'm going to give you some different types of forward rolls that I want you to do. But before we do that, what I want you to just make sure is that you've done some standing egg rolls for your forward rolls to start off with. Okay, so I'm going to demo some egg rolls. I'll give you a little bit of time and then you can do them. A little practice and then we're ready to get rolling.
Okay, here are going to be our 3 different rotational skills that we're going to do, and we're going to start off with a forward roll. Our next is going to be a straddle roll, so this time we are starting in the straddle position from our hip. We're going to set up, we're going to roll through to a landing position. And our third that we're going to do is a rock to shoulder stand that we use for choreography. Have a go at all 3 and see how you get on. Okay, so now we have finished our forward rotations. I'm going to roll the dice again and see what number we get so we know what we're moving on to. Okay, let's see. Okay, so it's rolled really far away from me, but we've rolled a 6. So that means we're going to have a go at some combination tumbles. Let's give it our best go. Okay, so we're going to go into some combinations. I'm going to give you 2 different combinations that I want you to have a go at, okay? The first combination I want you to try is a forward roll into a cartwheel. Okay, the next one I'd like you to try is a straddle roll into a round-off. Run.
Okay, roll three. Let's see what we get this time. Five. That means for number five, we are going to go in with some handstand drills. Remember, ask a grown-up before we do. Okay, so I'm going to go into some handstand drills now. Of course, you can do handstands without anything to hold you. For this handstand drill, I am going to use the wall behind me, but it's really, really important that I am being safely monitored whilst I'm doing this, because I need to make sure that I'm not going to come to any danger, and most importantly, I've got a safety mat behind me. I'm going to go from my tumble stance into a handstand. I'm going to try and hover slightly away from the wall, and the wall is just there as a guideline to make sure that I don't go over. I'm going to keep my arms nice and locked, squeeze in my core, hold the handstand for no longer than three, and then I'm going to come back down. And that's something that I can repeat again and again and again to help me improve my core and the handstand itself. Okay? Just like this. Okay, we're back again. Those handstands, I'm sure, were perfect. Let's give it another roll to see what we're going to do next. Okay, so that has rolled on to four, which means we are going in with jump connectors. Let's give it a go. Okay, so we're going to try some tumble and jump connectors. So I'm going to give you two different tumble and jump connectors to do. Both of these are used in routines and we use them in our school programs and everywhere that we go. So what I want you to have a go at first of all is our egg roll into T-jump. Okay, so we're going to start forward here, we're going to rock back into an egg roll and then T-jump on our way up. And again. Okay, this time we're going to do a forward roll into a top jump as a jump connector. And again. Okay, so we've got our final drill that we're going to do next, which goes into our cartwheel challenges. Hopefully that adding the dice in has made it that little bit more fun for you. So our final thing to work on today are our cartwheels. Let's go. Okay, first skill, cartwheel. Our second skill, we are going to do a cartwheel, but we're going to turn out at the end. Our third skill, we are going to cartwheel one-handed. And finally, we are going to round off. Have a go, see how you get on. Okay, thank you for coming and tumbling with me. Hopefully we can do this again soon and you can keep practicing in the meantime.